Hello, I'm Morka, and I'm bringing you another commentary on my YouTube channel. This game is actually recently played on December, and you guys gonna watch it in the end of January. Yeah, it was played, I think, on the 4th December or something. And I'm playing with Surfer and Phantom versus Steven, Nate and McKay. I'm the Brute on my team.
Bereit.
Alle Einheiten.
Tu es. Kann losgehen.
With a Prophet and the Orbi versus three Orbis.
Aufgetankt. Bereit.
Tempo first Brute.
Lokale Einheiten.
Server was saying at the beginning, boys, make sure you get scissors. Go to the first, at least that we don't get cheese in this combo. We have a better chance in the mid or mid end late game. Those guys have the best chance to win in the early game if they cheese. You only need 5 grunts to cheese a base. With 3 Orbis going to 1 base, they can build 6 grunts after the 1.5 minute mark. After the 1.5 minute mark. The second grunt is out. Or what you can say, if you have 3 pets and they are going temple first, they have 3 grunts out. If they go temple second, they have 2 grunts after the second minute.
Ja, alles bereit.
Lokale Einheiten.
Bin auf dem Weg. Ja.
And the upgrade to the Citadel base needs 30 seconds.
Ich bin hier.
Then we maybe talk about the Orbi also need like quite a few seconds if they join your base. But you really need to make sure you get silver. And I'm at least wanted to build 3 Brutes. Then I recycled my temple. And I'm building Citadel at my 4th Brute. And there we go, there comes the cheese. Our teammates saying, well, we lost. And there we go. This is perfect in time. And those guys sending the grunts even into my base, which I love. I love seeing this stuff. 4 grunts on my base. More damage than 3 guys on my base right now. We love this.
Ich gehorche. Verstehe.
Got a Prophet playing defense with Owner Gods. My Prophet don't even need to upgrade Prophet. He could if he's scared about eating a grunt. Because then the shield can sponge more damage. Those guys did actually a good amount of damage on my base. The red army recalled and trying to push me off. They're trying to get some pads up. I'm getting pads up, trying to build a back turret to save my upcoming pad right now. That is the planning. My teammate failed miserably. Because the shield is gonna get up. But sometimes it is what it is. I really don't know why he's not raging down the shield when he's seen that, when he sees that the shield is like 75% up. I think he was banking that the suicide run is coming in time. I got my turret up, which is hard for them to deny my pets right now. And I actually could have started another turret. But I really don't want to because they are not hitting me anymore. I have two arbiters raging down my brood. I don't want to lose the brood. Usually you say it is not a good idea to recall in triple cover matches, but I don't have a temper. I cannot rebuild my brood. If I would have had a temper, I would not do stuff like that. Then I assume it's better to rebuild brood. But my thinking behind that was I want to build an Angie or two, then build a hall and don't even build a temple and go up and do more damage. And those armies are loving me. They love me so much. Getting the heal off that one. I recycled the turret at least. And he wanna swim my turret.
Auf geht's! Zeig mir die Richtung! Was?
Our opponent has a war. Our army has a war.
Bereit! Zu Befehl!
Yeah! Our army has a war. And on triple cubby games, it's usually halls versus halls or vamps versus vamps. Getting my turret up again. Army's red bomb. Trying to use my chopper to ram these red orb thingy. And oh no, we really, really lost. I want to make sure that this time you don't get the heal back. In my second turret, he recalled because he saw the hole from my orbiter teammate. So fucking tired, but I wanna at least recall the videos for him. And I'm building my engine now from one pass. I love that. Usually you can argue, you can recycle the turrets right now because you push those guys off and if they hit you, would it be good for your team, because your teammates definitely will have a better eco or at least one or two upgraded pads. So if you recycle the turrets and you make them think that they can hit you and they are hitting you instead of your teammates, it would have been actually good for your team. But recycling those turrets is not cost effective. And you guys remembered, those guys only hit me the entire game. They pushed me, tried to cheese me, pushed me on two pads. And then after the first push, they come to me again. They didn't went to another person. So this might be also a reason why I hold this those two turrets. I told Phantom at least I can heal him with my Engie. Got my own Engie right now. After I realized that they are going raids, I assumed it's not a good idea to go whole as well, without even having a temple. This is the reason why I really was thinking I'd go temple and go benches from there. But that in case was not the plan. This was the main reason why I was building engineers. And the other team also had engineers. My teammate don't really realize that. Could fly in. Focus down this edge. I assumed he was too scary about this army. Yeah, and I'm clicking on that to tell my teammate, please, please kill the enemy, please, just do it. And somehow, I really don't know how my teammates did that, but somehow the base is red ball. And the Prophet has an upgraded beam and beamed down the base. And they don't have any engines left, and Yellow actually is losing the base. I really don't know how this happened. But I appreciate that my teammates actually done it. And I was thinking, what can I do? Also versus raids, and I assumed I can upgrade my vortex. I don't have the money to double pump because I don't have upgraded heads. And I don't want to make my teammate lose more of his things. This is why I'm sending my engines to his base. Trying to counter heal his heads and vortexing down the raids, which actually worked really good. Two raids down. Another raid down, my Banshees are kinda healing my Banshees. Three hogs, three raids down. I'm trying to catch these last two raids. And I have the option to counter push to the base on Yellow was taken down, that I can deny him taking the base. My Angie doing busy healing. So for some reason I really was looking that we cleared the last raid. And now it is 2v3. Nate's still on the shields. My teammates don't have any shields. We are building turrets. Less shields makes more units. And there is the resign. That was a good game. I hope you enjoy it. Leave a like here, put a commentary on. And I'll see you guys in the next commentary.